There is power in your mindset. Everyone has both positive and negative perspectives, but your mindset is determined by the dominant outlook. In what direction do you lean most of the time? Hello and thank you. Welcome to my channel. My name is Catherine Gahu and I'm an entrepreneur. Over the years, while running a business and experiencing all the ups, the downs, and the in-betweens, I have come to recognize the power of mindset and how it impacts my life, career, and business. Research shows that a positive mindset is important because it helps improve your confidence, your well-being, your health, your relationships, and your overall happiness. I think these are important goals that are worth pursuing. Don't you think? Positive mindset focuses on the overall outlook in life. Having a positive mindset does not mean that you're not aware of the bad and the ugly side of life. No, not at all. What it means is that while aware of all that, you consciously choose to focus on the good a lot more than the bad. It's a choice you make. Let us test our mindsets. Consider this question. Would you say that your mindset tends towards positive rarely? One, once in a while? Two, or most of the time? Three. If your answer is one or two, let's continue and learn how to shift that mindset to the positive direction, because it matters. The five habits to maintaining a positive mindset. First, choose a positive mental diet. Your mind is affected by what you feed it most of the time. To shift to a positive perspective, you need to ensure that the books you read, the movies you watch, the music you listen to, and your social media activities are inclined to what you want and not what you don't want. Consciously feed your mind with positive thoughts, ideas, information, songs, movies, discussions, and engagements. It helps to read books, watch videos or movies, attend courses or webinars that help you feel more competent, more confident, more in control, happy, more empowered, and inspired. Second, practice positive self-conversation. We all have that inner self-conversation, a kind of self-talk going on in our minds, especially relating to important decisions and situations in our lives. You need to direct that conversation to a positive direction. Be conscious of the conversation. When you find it going on in your mind, when it's negative, find a way to shift it by interrupting it. You can interrupt it by recalling a positive image or time when things were going better. Bring that to the fore and it will help you get away from the negative mindset. Recall a good memory and you cannot continue having the negative image, because normally the mind cannot hold two conflicting perspectives at the same time. The more positive your self-talk, the more you will lean to a positive mindset. To quote Edmund Bierker, positive self-talk is to emotional pain as a pain pill is to physical pain. The third, learn a new skill. We always want to get better at something. Skills training and self-development helps engage and focus our minds to things that are important. Whether it's learning Kikuyu or Japanese language, or it's how to play the guitar, it doesn't really matter. When you are engaged in learning a new skill, your feelings, your attitudes, your beliefs and thoughts tend to shift towards a more positive direction. Research has shown that learning a new skill gives you a greater sense of control over your life and keeps you in a positive mindset. It was Mahatma Gandhi who said, "Live as if you will die tomorrow, but learn as if you will live forever." Fourth, practice appreciative inquiry. When faced with a negative situation, decide to search for something to appreciate in that situation. Train your mind to practice appreciative inquiry, a mind that is always looking for what is working, what is good, and what's favorable. Always find something to celebrate. You need to focus on what is working for you. You always have something working for you. It could be your skills, It could be your networks or whatever. Skills represent know-how and networks represent know-who. If you don't know how, you can find someone who knows that which you need to know. Appreciative inquiry keeps you in a positive mindset by encouraging you to always have gratitude, to be grateful about what's happening, what's good in everything that's happening in your life. A grateful spirit enables you to stay in a positive direction. One of the exercises I ask people who ask me how to move their mind to positive to do is to write a gratefulness journal, where you write the things you are grateful about. You start by writing 50 things you're grateful about, and you find you can go to 100, and then another 100, and another. By the time you reach 100, you definitely will have shifted your mindset to a more positive direction. I like what the song "You Raise Me Up" by Josh Groban says. It seems like something like, "You raise me up so I can stand on mountains," or something like that. When troubles come and my heart is burdened, I wait here in silence until you come and sit a while with me. That shows a mind practicing appreciative inquiry. Number 5, hang out with positive people. I know people say, "How do I choose who to hang out with?" No. You have the choice. Decide to spend more time with positive people. The people you spend the most time with have the greatest power to impact your mindset. They influence your thought, your attitude, and your behavior. In your life, there will always be positive and negative people. The issue is to take a conscious decision to increase the interaction with the positive people, and that means you seek them out. You seek out the more positive people and you minimize your involvement with the negative people. Decide to use the 80-20 rule, which says you spend the 80% of your time with the more positive people and 20% can go to all the others. To sum up, the 5 ways to maintaining a positive mindset. 1, choose a positive mental diet. 2, practice positive self-conversation. 3, learn a new skill. 4, practice appreciative inquiry. 5, hang out with positive people. Thank you for watching this video. Remember to subscribe and like it so that we can bring you more like it. Don't forget to press notifications so that you can be notified of other relevant videos. Before I close, I have a question for you. What action will you take in the next few days to shift your mindset to the positive? We all need to elevate our mindsets at this time. Thank you and best wishes.